difficult that there's so little songs from that game that they're every single song of that game is a banger, you know? But there's like a little list. But of course, one of the best, it's gonna be Night of Fate. That's gonna be the first game of the last match of the last set of these full C. That's gonna be starting up with Bonilla and Reggie.
Sabroso, fiero pariente, let's start this match, man. I got you, don't you worry about that. What I'm seeing right now is the immediate startup from Reggie. Matter of fact, Reggie here representing. Be careful now, because the platforms, they help out quite a lot. He ate all of that down smash. Like, it was a crispy frame. No, what are you doing, Bonilla? What is going on? You did so well with the execution in regards to eating that down smash with the blazer, and then you SD with the dam, with the side, with double-edged dam. What is going on, man? That's not something that you like to see. Be careful, because those type of things shatter mentalities towards the start, because players generally tend to have like two mentalities. Either, oh no, this is going very, very bad, or okay, you know what? I'm gonna use this because this made me a lot angrier. Finally, we're going to be seeing that back here, but Reggie is already making that percentage rack up, seeing that Bonilla can sometimes falter in regards to the execution, but with the get-up attack, is able to take it out. The fear, we saw an SD coming from Bonilla, unfortunately, by missing, continuing to input a side
beat, and we're seeing that Reggie is in the lead. There's some classical. It's a classic. It's not canceled. It's not canceled. It's a forbidden tech. It's a forbidden jutsu from the Hidden Leaf Village in the south. That's quite unfortunate coming from Bonilla. It's like a tradition. Every single time that we go to a big event, one of us just stuck cancels the very first match of the very first game. I don't know why, but it happens. In any case, I am quite glad that things have been evening up after that happened, because as you can already tell, both of these players are already at kill percent. It doesn't matter what happens after this. What happens is that someone is gonna die within the next 15 seconds or less. Oh my god, I saw the future so hard.
Gaze into the future. Can't continue singing that song because of copyright. But we're gonna start off immediately with Bonilla once again regaining the momentum, and that's exactly what I was mentioning before. That sometimes players, what they use is that they use the fact that they lost a stock at a percentage that they shouldn't have in order to use that as fuel for a better stock, for a better game, and for a better result in the end. And I want to say for a better future, but the same show as we're seeing right now. Careful, Reggie constantly with the percentage. He already tied this up. We went the dash dance right there, extending his combo even more. Jesus Christ, stop this man! Stop this man! All that combo should be illegal, but Bonilla immediately stopping him out as he were a... I really don't know what he was, but he was just like the unstoppable force right there against the immovable object. And now we're seeing a reset to neutral in which both of these players are constantly struggling in the power battle that is Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, like you're seeing right now.
Of course, this is an 85 against 102%, but Bonilla just currently fishing for anything, any kind of interaction that could possibly give him an edge on this very first match. Of course, como decía mi abuelo, as my granddad once said, anyone can take out the first game, but as long as you take the first game, of course you're gonna take or have any kind of advantage for the coming up set. It's already 142%. It's probably gonna be a portal what's gonna close this out, but I don't know whose portal it's gonna be, because of course both of them worked so hard, so great, so brave, and that's gonna be enough.
Finally, Franklin going out of his way to get back, but you know that standard Mr. Game & Watch edgeguard, ladies and gentlemen, you know that stuff is bread and butter. If you are not edgeguarding as Mr. Game & Watch, what are you doing? And that's exactly what Reggie demonstrates right now, especially with someone with a recovery so exploitable as Roy with his Biting Blade and everything. But I mean, eventually those flames have to die out, like we just saw, and Bonilla is unfortunately one game below Reggie, which I see him being able to come back from this. But if Reggie starts to get that snowball momentum that we've seen on some occasions, that's game over, man. Just game over.
As long as people get that snowball momentum, they are able to take on their opponents. But one thing that I have noticed, that was one thing that you mentioned earlier before, it's the better player check. who's the better player? I feel like you could tell it could rely on mechanics, it could rely on tech skill, it could rely on ability and agility, or even reaction or decision making. I feel like one of the better players is the one that's able to handle the snowball momentum and come back from it. Because most players at that point where you feel like I just lost and that was quite bad, what's gonna happen afterwards, they just lose every single piece of or inch of confidence that they had in themselves, and they don't make it back. But the better player does make it back, and I know that Bonilla can make it back as well.
Well, we'll have to see it, because actions speak louder than words, and we're seeing that right now Reggie is a person that is currently within the advantage. Not necessarily within percentage, because I really don't mean that at all, but we're seeing that he's using a lot of the options that we're seeing right now. Franklin once again makes an appearance, take the turtle head, and we're going to immediately run back towards the center of the stage. But once again, Jesus, the nightmare that is that jab back air for every single main that has a lightweight as a character. Jesus Christ, like we're seeing right now, those have been here like hot bread, man. I'm talking like they've been delivering like hot bread, and we're seeing them exactly right there. That Reggie is the one that's actually beating all that hot bread, because he's doing every single wonderful jab back.
Just of course. And once again, getting back into the road, Bonilla already making a statement. That's exactly how we see every single time that I see Bonilla playing. This is how things roll out. This is how things play out. Bonilla just roller coasting against his opponents, then one single interaction just throws him off a little bit, and that's just snowball's effect into something that he cannot recover from. What's gonna happen afterwards? Someone's gonna lose the stock within the next 15 seconds. Who is it gonna be? I don't know. But of course, I feel like slowly but surely it's gonna be Bonilla, of course. I once again foresaw the future. I love it.
Somebody's gonna take the stock within the next 5 minutes. Well, yeah, I mean, come on, man.
Of course,
somebody's gonna lose the stock. Yeah, somebody's gonna lose the stock right now. I mean, go coming. Yeah, I see the future. Come on, man.
Next time I'm gonna say 10 seconds, I'm gonna get lower and lower, and then I'm gonna get it up right.
Say 3 seconds next time. See if you're so badass.
Nah, it just goes lower and lower, but not that lower. In any case, this is already 44 against 33%. Already on Bonilla's side. Are just snowballing a little bit closer and closer against Reggie. But what's gonna happen? As you can already tell, he's exerting such a great ledge trip against this mastermind that is Reggie Shikai. I mean, but for how long? Of course, at some point, you just gotta go back, give them a little bit of a space, don't overextend yourself, because that's what's gonna happen. And that's exactly what she said. It's gonna be a 2-0 on Reggie's side. It's not game over, but of course, this is something that it's exerting such a great pressure on Bonilla.
Careful is everything that I have to say. You saw him tech those beforehand. We saw him on various occasions be able to come back to those type of situations, but what makes Mr. Game & Watch back air so difficult to tech on sometimes is the fact that it's a multi-hit. And that multi-hit can vary the time that you have to tech off of the stage. And you see, that's what I understand, right? But oh, look, it's your boy, man. It's your boy. He's coming on the stage. We're going to be seeing this, the one who repels the darkness. It is Sora at Hollow Bastion. It seems like he's asking for his transfer power to defeat the Heartless. That is Mr. Game & Watch. Jesus Christ, don't tell me he's dead.
No, it's not that. He's not that. Of course, that's not gonna be it. He's gonna make it back. Of course, it's Sora we're talking about. He was gonna make it back anyways. He didn't even need that check into the stage. So, what you're referring to, it's Sora. We're Hollow Bastion. May he need his heart. May he need his friends. I believe that's a necessity at this point, of course. There's something must change if he wants to take on Reggie. He already had the good idea of what to do against Reggie, but what was he lacking was how to close it out. And I feel like Sora may not be. Ooh, okay, that bucket is just half. It's the third.
Yeah, but I mean, come on, it closed off your stay right there, because it was like, oh no, you gotta be careful in those types of situations, because that bucket, once it fills up, you dump it. We've seen it time and time again, that it just hurts ever so much. You can't place a shield, but Jesus Christ, what a great up smash right there. That final hitbox can be a bit deceiving, like the Sakurai mentioned, but Jesus, we're seeing it right here. Yeah, of course. Once it it's like the fifth pick with extra steps. You're gonna get punished wherever you land after that side B, and you saw it effectively right now. We see that, you know, after he got that bucket filled up halfway, Bonilla hasn't really thrown out a lot of projectiles.
No, he just throws an album unless he really needs to. And of course, if he were to do so right now, that's just gonna be any kind of a conditioning tool instead of just an edge strap tool, a leg strap tool. As you can already tell, this is such a situation that has Bonilla on edge. He's been able to take on all that percentage against Reggie, but what's gonna happen afterwards? As you can, you already know, you already see, the bucket is just full and empty. Once again, Bonilla's on the rope. He's already losing on this merge, and once again, this is gonna be the last duck and possibly the first 3-0 that we... Is it the first 3-0 or...?
No.
No,
we saw Bonilla with the Bonilla Goblin with the first 3-0.
Yeah, another 3-0 on Bonilla's side, that's sadly. But of course, not before giving up a fight that's gonna be a not be out of shield, but as long as you're not that close to the blast zone, then it's not gonna be as effective as you may imagine.
Zora is one of those characters that can easily take an opponent out. But the thing is, he's also one of those characters that can easily be taken out because he's so light, he's so mobile within the air. But at the same time, you know, he's a 40 character and he dies very easily.
Like, his advantage is quite bad.
Of course, he manages to make it back. And with that sighting, you have to be wary of exactly where Zora is, because if you don't take that into consideration, it's something that you will be paying for, especially right now with the neutral getup. But that jab is going to be fine right there with the Thundaga trying to get back. But no, absorbed in the pocket and with the chair, pégale con la silla, because this is a 3-0 and we're going straight into the end of this pool, my man, because that chair is looking mighty good. Sit down, Bonilla, because I'm taking third seed.
That's the lady chair, if you ask me, la silla señora. La silla señora. Sadly, that's gonna be it for Bonilla. On this pool, of course, shout out to Reggie once again making it against Bonilla and actually winning, being the victorious one on this side of the set. And I'm not entirely sure, I feel like this is not only the